the Aquatic Research Center, a high-security research facility where Solarians work on various projects such as new tech, including medical and weaponry. But secretly they use test subjects Lunarians captured in battle made a perfect option, doing cruel and monstrous experiments on whatever tickled their fancy. I was used often to test and refine the restraints they used to keep us imprisoned.
Things 3 and 4 are capacity 76%. Others holding at 68%. Subject is still conscious.
Increase input by 15% and keep an eye on vitals.
Subject lost consciousness at 86%. Links 3 and 4 held at 77%.
My body was usually numb as they dragged me back to my cell. I fought back whenever I could move, but their control and my restraints always brought about the same outcome. I was maddening being repeatedly put into such a weak and helpless state. Every day my hatred toward them grew. We weren't even animals to them, but me to test their devices on. Only one thing drowsed my hatred of them. Maria, the granddaughter of Dr. Gerald and had lived here nearly her entire life. She was nothing like the other Solarians. She chose to tend to all Lunarians, even if it put her in danger at times. She was the only one who ever asked my name. Got so used to her daily visits, I came to look forward to them. Nothing else mattered when she was with me. I just wanted her there. She gave me the kind of peace in that hellish place.
And how is our subject today?
Oh, Professor Shura, good evening.
237 did well in today's tests.
I wish you wouldn't harm the Lunarians so much. At least give them some time to rest if you must torture them.
But your care is doing wonders for them. Their survival rate is up 63% since you started tending to them.
I don't do it for you. It's terrible the way they're treated.
However, we're done with 237 for now. You can take 3 days off. For recovery.
Thank you. I must go and tend to the others. Good day.
Good day.
Greetings, Maria. Here's today's chart. Most critical subjects are new entries.
Thank you. Some of these are just children.
No more! Stay away! Don't hurt me! I didn't mean
no
to!
No more!
Shh,
stay away!
What's your name?
Silver.
Hello, Silver. My name is Maria. I'm going to help treat your injuries. Is that alright?
Yes.
First, I'm going to clean the wound. This will sting a bit. Ready?
Okay. Ow!
Now, we wrap them up. Does that feel any better?
Yeah.
I can tend to your wound too if you'd like. Don't be afraid. Would you like to help? There we go. You did a great job.
I'm sorry.
Oh, you don't have to apologize at all. There. No need to worry. I just wish I could do more for you all.
No use in hiding. I know you're there. They're going to catch you one of these days if you keep roaming around the vents, Mephiles.
No worries. You'd be amazed how much the Solarians drop their guard once they believe they've tamed you. I saw your nurse in here earlier. Even for a Solarian, she is lovely. She'll make a nice pet.
That's no concern of yours.
It matters not to me. As long as you don't get distracted from who the real enemy is.
I could never forget.
Foolishly blinded into thinking they're the superior ones. They will learn in time who's truly superior. And oh, what bliss that will be.
Shadow! I have amazing news. Professor Shura has allowed me to take you to the research garden. As long as you behave. But I know I don't have to worry about that. Right?
Right.
This is my favorite place on the Ark. The lunar lilies grown there are so lovely. I once heard a story about how they bloom at dusk in order to greet the rising moon. I'm so glad I can finally share this place with you. Not only are the flowers amazing, but this area has the largest screen ceiling to mimic the real night sky to make them bloom. See? Aren't they beautiful? Their glow is so lovely. I love this place. For the flowers, yes, but mainly for the ceiling. I've never been outside the Ark because of my illness, so I've never seen the real sky. Been told how it stretches far as you can see and the various dazzling colors it shifts to. I wish to see it one day.
Your illness was cured just over a year ago, wasn't it? Why didn't you leave then?
I thought about it, but afraid I wouldn't be strong enough to return. I couldn't just abandon all the Lunarians here. The very first ones are here because of me. Grandfather Gerald brought me here, since could have an environment 100% controlled, to keep me safe as he looked for a cure. I learned that they brought the first Lunarian test subjects here to experiment on for a cure. I owe them my life. So I swore to myself I'd be free of this place only when they are too.
That just means we'll both get to see each other one day. Together.
Right.
Anyone in here? Hi, Maria.
Hello, Dr. Starline. I was just taking a break in here.
Was wondering why it said occupied when our experiments were scheduled.
Yeah, it was just me. I'll be sure to lock up once done.
Very well. Good day.
I thought you had permission.
I do, but I also know those don't agree with the professor at times, and didn't want any reason to send you back early.
So this is where it comes from.
What?
You always had a subtle sense of flowers on you. Started to think I imagined it. Maria, I know how you feel. I know you return at least some of them. Would you allow me to mark you with my kiss?
Yes.
Close your eyes.
Will it hurt?
I won't harm you. Now you are marked as mine, my flower.
My gentle shadow.